We have always assumed that international travel would be some way off. And, you know, in relation to business travel, I suspect that businesses around the world have adapted to the circumstances that we're in, and that a lot of the business engagement now happens, you know, at a digital level. In relation to tourism, I mean, yes, I mean, it'll take some time for international tourists to be able to come back to Australia in the way they did in the past. But it also, we're also in a situation where travelers out of Australia will be restricted in their capacity to travel internationally. So there'll be a level of substitution domestically in Australia in terms of some of that tourism market. And so some areas, like international students, I mean, we do believe that there will be capacity to put appropriate risk management processes in place, you know, when somebody intends to come to Australia over an extended period. And that is a very important, that is a very important export earner for us, the international student market.
I remember back in 2014, the level of Chinese tourism or education spending here in Australia is basically at the level where India is right now. Much in the same vein as we looked for other markets for our barley exports, is there going to be more of a concerted push towards perhaps education exports from India and from other countries if this does continue?
Well, it's not a matter of if this does continue. I mean, we've always been focused on diversifying as much as possible our trade opportunities. I mean, we have been pursuing a very ambitious trade agenda and, you know, entering into free trade agreements, you know, with countries all around the world, including, you know, Japan, South Korea, Indonesia. We are in a process now with the European Union and the United Kingdom. And indeed, we would like to think that we can land an agreement with India. But we've always been, you know, Australia is a globally focused, outward-looking trading nation. We are an exporting nation. And, you know, we want to sell Australian products and services into as many markets around the world as possible. And that is something that we have been focused on in the past and will continue to focus on in the future.
And Minister, China is arguably one of the, if not the most important of these markets. And your Prime Minister has said that the government will not be intimidated by threats coming from China. But can you afford right now not to have good economic ties with China?
Well, you know, we want to have the best possible relationship with China, but we also will stand up for our national interests. I mean, from time to time, in a mutually beneficial relationship, there will be disagreement on specific issues, and our view is that those issues should be worked through constructively and positively. You know, it is a very important trade relationship, and we do have a strategic partnership as well, a comprehensive strategic partnership. And, you know, we want that relationship to be in the best possible shape. But, you know, when there are issues where Australia's national interest is at stake, we will stand up for our national interests.